just avoid me. They run and they hide. Are my colors too bright? Are my eyes set too high? I spend my whole life burning, turning. I'm a teenage Frankenstein, the local freak with a twisted mind. I'm a teenage Frankenstein. These ain't my hands and these legs ain't mine.
Like, we're back on Friday the 13th, the Dudes of Horror, Damien.
I'm Toots.
And Wormboy, what's up?
Part 6, Jason Lives.
Yeah, like, I've always liked this one since I was a kid. And yeah, some of the characters are so dumb.
But it's funny.
Yeah, it's funny. Like, it's just a fun movie.
But what's important to note is the filmmaker's characters dumb. Like, purposely made them, like, those one-off, like...
One-dimensional.
One-dimensional horror movie characters.
Yeah.
Like, the dumb blonde, the jock, the idiot counselors, the idiot town, like, small-town sheriff.
Yeah, someone has to be an idiot, someone has to be horny, someone has to be dumb. Which is a group, like, for Halloween or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it's just when I was like, oh, check this out, that's where her face goes through the wall. Like,
yeah.
And she makes an imprint on it.
No, but it's important, like what we were talking about when we were rolling, that what it's important to note is to give the filmmakers credit is that this one is, like, self-referential.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there are, like, this is still a franchise, like, in the 80s, like, in the heart of the 80s, but they're already, like, making fun of the genre.
Mm-hmm.
They're already, like, making fun of the genre cliches, like, within the actual franchise.
I think... Most of those movies, like Friday the 13th, Nightmare on Elm Street, I think at one point, especially, like, for instance, with this movie, it's part 6. With Nightmare on Elm Street, it's, like, usually, like, part 4, or, you know, part 4, part 5, where they just stop taking everything seriously, and, like, yeah. They just have fun with it.
Yeah, and it works.
Yeah.
It yeah. Like, yeah, that movie sucks.
Oh, God.
Well, but... The whole amazing plot of part 6 of Jason Lives is
it's Tommy's fault.
Tommy Jarvis is back, older now, and him and his buddy, what's his name, Hollis?
Oh, Horshack.
Yeah, but in part 6, he's Hollis or something like that.
Something like that. I just call him Horshack.
Well, they're on their way to the graveyard at the beginning of the movie to, like, destroy Jason's body once and for all, and Tommy's, like, has all this, like, post-traumatic stress or something.
Yeah.
Like, he's hallucinating or...
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they go and dig up his body, and then Tommy starts freaking out when he sees his body, and you actually hear the voiceover flashbacks of Corey Feldman. when he's chopping him up. When he's chopping him up in part 4. So Tommy starts freaking out, and he grabs a metal rod and starts stabbing Jason's body.
Yeah.
And then, like, you just see the close-up shot of Jason's eye, like, open up after, because then the rod gets struck by lightning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it wakes up Jason, I don't know. And it gives Jason superpowers, apparently.
Apparently, yeah.
They never explain it.
Like, is it Super Jason now?
Because it's like the same thing as, like, Frankenstein's monster.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and then he can, I don't know. Like, that's basically the entire plot of the movie.
Yeah, that's pretty much. So pretty much, you can call this movie Tommy's fault for bringing back Jason.
Yeah, and then you have the daughter of the sheriff, which is, like, trying to get with Tommy. So she helps him.
Yeah, she's the only one that, like, believes him.
And then. The sheriff.
Out of here! My heart can't take much more of this. I'm like, what does he mean that he's gonna have a heart attack or what?
Like, yeah, to me, it just sounds like a little bitch.
But some of the lines in this movie are just great. But it's, I don't know, like, I like this movie. Like,
oh, go ahead.
I actually like the movie. Like, it's really entertaining to watch. Like, and I think it's, like I said, like. They're having fun with the genre tropes and cliches, like, actually in the franchise. Like, this isn't, like, a parody of Friday the 13th.
Mm-hmm.
This is a Friday the 13th movie.
Yeah.
But they're like embracing the cliches of it. Like, I think that's cool. Like,
yeah, like, no, I was gonna go back to what you were saying about
what?
About Tommy's friend, about Horshack. And it's just like, yeah, he's a little bitch. He just bitches and moans. And I'm like, how would you be if a friend of yours or someone you know went,
here
like,
we go.
Yeah, it's like, hey, come with me. Where are we going? Just come with me. Go in the car. All right, we're going to the cemetery. Why? Who are you going to visit? Just come on. We're going to the cemetery. And then he explains his plot all the way, and then you have no choice because you're not driving.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'll just be like, hey, let's get out of here. But I wouldn't say, oh, my heart's beating so hard. I can't take this no more.
It's just the way the line's written.
Oh,
it's like,
yeah.
It's, I don't know.
No, I mean, I think I would be like... okay,
like freaking
like,
out, like, why?
Like, why are we doing this again?
Just to make sure he's dead. He hasn't been around for a while. Why are you...
I'm like, Tommy, you're seriously ill. You need
yeah.
to go back to...
Well, so then Tommy goes to... Because... Well, I actually looked it up, so we can just like make it clear. It's Ron Palillo.
Yeah, Ron Palillo or Ron Palillo, however you want to pronounce it.
Yeah.
Palillo.
So,
yeah.
Well, he gets killed, and then because he had just said my heart can't take any more of this, and Jason like punches right through him like
gets his heart
Terminator style.
Yeah.
But instead of that, instead of the fist coming through, he has his heart on
yeah.
the other side.
But if you notice, well, maybe I saw it wrong, it seems like his hand is like in a completely different place than where the heart would be, right?
Yeah,
that's what they're doing.
Yeah.
So like, how did you get the heart? Did you go in there first and then kind of move?
It's the magic powers from the lightning, I'm telling you.
But that's an example of, like, the filmmakers, they're not trying to make a serious, accurate
movie.
Horror
yeah.
movie. Like, they're just having fun with all this. Of course, the sheriff doesn't believe them. But the sheriff starts saying, like, that's why we changed the name to Forest Green.
Because that makes it all better.
Yeah, because
well,
nobody...
Jason's going to know where Crystal Lake really is, because he just knows.
Yeah. Cause but that's the thing. It's like, he's like, the sheriff is, like, saying it, like, because no one wants to remember all that. Like, so you need to go back where you came from, Tommy.
Get out of here.
Which is a bit absurd, because it's like, nobody wants to remember all that. I don't think most people will forget that relatives died there. So.
Yeah. So then Tommy ends up getting arrested. And then, like, the sheriff's daughter and all of her friends show up. And they happen to be the... Yeah. And they happen to be the new camp counselors. And the sheriff, after hearing all of this from Tommy, he still lets his daughter and all of her friends go to the camp.
Mm-hmm.
And, despite Tommy's warnings, like, it's just stupid. And then he's like, no, you gotta warn them. But he's in the jail cell. So of course, like, and all, like, it's just the classic Friday the 13th. They go to the camp, but there's actually kids at the camp in this one. Like,
mm-hmm.
it's actually a functioning summer camp for once. But now it's Forest Green. It's not Camp Crystal Lake.
You think after like the fourth movie, or maybe even the fifth movie, they would have no longer used the property and made it like a memorial. Like, all right, let's just move on.
Like, and be like, we don't want to put kids here, even though we're trying to forget by changing the name.
Yeah.
And then this guy comes out and he's like, dude, he's out there.
Let's remember the counselors who died while fucking. And then just like, let's move on.
And there is, and it's like, why would somebody want to work there?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, after like the curse has just been like, so many times they tried to reopen the camp, and like everybody gets massacred there, like, and a killer's never obviously caught, because you know what I mean. Jason always gets away, so it's like.
And usually it's like when they're preparing to open it and everything, and then that's when people get killed. I'm just picturing the one kid that's like, okay, finally I'm gonna go this year. Ah, fuck, people died. All right, next year.
True.
So for 5 years in a row,
no, people died again.
Damn it!
There is that great shot, like it went at the end when Tommy's like the big finale you were talking about.
Yeah,
where Tommy gets the rope with the boulder around Jason's neck.
Yeah, the chain.
And there's the chain. And there's that great shot of the old Camp Crystal Lake sign, like underwater, where somebody had gone with spray paint and put Camp Blood.
Yeah,
like. And I was like, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like, I honestly thought that was a pretty cool, like, little nod.
Yeah, but you were right about how the filmmakers and like even the characters, like sometimes their motivations are kind of warped, because like the scene that you were talking about earlier before we started recording, how this little girl shows up with a machete and the counselor is like, oh yeah, it's, you know, and just tosses it aside.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Like after most of the counselors have already been picked off and there's one more and she's asleep, and the little girl is like I think like the poor man's the poor man's Reagan from, not Reagan, the little girl from Poltergeist.
Oh,
I can't think of her name. Carrie Ann.
Caroline.
Caroline.
Yeah, Caroline.
And she's walking towards her, but the whole shot is just like the big bloody machete in the frame going towards her, so you think it's Jason.
Mm-hmm.
And then like they cut to the wide shot, and it's the little girl. And she's and the camp counselor just wakes
up. I actually thought when I first saw it, it was actually Jason. So
yeah,
I think
that's what you're supposed
there.
To think.
And then it's like, the little girl. I was like, oh shit.
But it's so stupid because she's actually holding a bloody, like with really fresh blood on it,
mm-hmm.
and a real machete with blood all over it. Yeah. And the counselor girl just grabs it. What are you doing with this? You shouldn't play with this. She's got it. She's got it really close to her face, so you would smell that blood.
Oh yeah.
And she just tosses it on the floor, never questioning why this child found a bloody machete outside. Because she's like, where'd you find this? And she's like, I found it outside. Like, so there's a real machete that's bloody.
Well, don't be playing with this, okay?
Yeah.
Go back to bed.
Yeah. And she's like, okay.
Any of her friends for a while.
Yeah.
But what was her excuse? She says something like, oh,
they're playing jokes.
Yeah.
Oh, they joke around like that or something.
They're playing pranks.
They're probably playing pranks on us. Like, don't take it seriously. I'm like, okay, that's not. But the part I couldn't stop laughing at was the part in the RV.
Mm-hmm.
Where they're having relations. And
having relations?
having sexual congress.
There's a song, I forgot the name of it, but they're like, ha, you know?
Yeah.
Teenage Frankenstein. No, but that's later when they're driving or anything.
I think so.
And I like it when Jason gets the girl into the bathroom and, you know, he's choking her, and that's where he imprints her face.
Yeah, that's
but
my favorite.
At the same
that's
time, the guy's like, hey, man, what's going on back there, man?
You taking
a shit?
Taking
a
shit? Or taking a dump?
Yeah.
You mind if I take a peek?
Yeah, I'm like, that's...
Are you sure you don't mind? Like, he kept on asking.
Like, he kept... That's what my wife was saying. Like,
probably has a shit fetish.
No, but she's like, how many times is he gonna say that? Because it's like they're not even making an excuse for why he's, like, just driving and not checking on her.
Yeah.
He's like, hey, you should come listen to the radio.
He's on the radio.
And that's the great teenage Frankenstein moment, the Alice Cooper song.
Yeah.
It was pretty cool, though, when Jason comes out and stabs him through the neck or through the head, right?
Through the head.
And then you see that it was a pretty badass wreck.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then he just comes out like nothing.
Yeah.
And they do the big epic shot where Jason's standing on top of the like tipped over
RV,
on fire RV.
And that looked awesome.
Yeah.
It was like it was like Jason's like music video moment or something.
I wonder when Alice Cooper like gave the rights like to his songs. I wonder if he's like, oh, by the way, can you play one of them while somebody's dying? Like that would have been cool if that was like his stipulation. Like, you have at least one playing when people die. Like, okay.
I like the part where he kills and I don't know, that's what we were talking about earlier. There's all these characters that are introduced that are not like
fleshed out.
The main characters.
Yeah.
Like, they're not the camp counselors, they're not the sheriff, they're not Tommy Jarvis, like the War Games people, like...
That was dumb.
Yeah, but there's like that cheesy military music, like...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah.
Like with the drums.
Yeah.
I like when the guy's running and he breaks the stick off the trying to put it back on the tree, like, what the fuck?
He's a dork.
No, but then when the lady shoots him and his friend, and she tells him, put on the headbands. Oh, the headbands that say dead.
Yeah.
So it's like, okay, they're about to die.
Yeah.
But then Jason, like, just steps out, and he's just standing there, and they all get scared at the what I was saying, like, the quick cuts to their faces. Where they're all just like, ah! and then with one swipe of his machete, he kills all three of them, even though the lady's standing behind the two guys.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. And then they embrace the cliche too, where the guy's running from Jason, mm-hmm. and Jason's just like doing his power walk.
Yeah.
But somehow he still catches up to him.
Yeah.
Like, lightning superpower.
Yeah.
But they show him just walking, and the guy's like full on running because it's like, fuck, there's a giant dude with a ski mask with the machete, so he's like running at his top speed. And Jason's just walking, but he still catches up to him.
Yeah. Yeah, it's funny how the girl's just standing there watching her friends die. Like, I understand curiosity will let you stick around for like the first swipe, but after that, I was like, ah, fuck this. And just start hauling us out of there. But
yeah, but like you told me, so what if you were in that situation?
Yeah. Seeing that tall guy with a hockey mask out
there. Which scene are you talking about though?
Well, the one that you were talking about where the military guys or whatever, like, Jason just comes out and just all three of them, like, kills them.
Oh, yeah. Well, that and the... I was thinking of another one right now. We have to note that Tony Goldwyn came out in this movie mm-hmm. briefly.
Yeah.
And he's gone on to do a lot of horror movies. Like, he was in the remake of Last House on the Left. And
the Belco Experiment. Yeah.
Ghost. That kind of mm-hmm. counts.
Yeah.
Ghost.
That kind of counts. There's some pretty creepy moments in that movie.
Mm-hmm.
but they're because you know there's always that cliche, like there's a camp counselor, or in part one it's the cook
mm-hmm.
that gets killed before they ever even make it to the camp, and everybody's wondering where they are, and it's him and I don't know, is it his chick, the redhead in the car with them? They're like in a bug.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's his girlfriend.
But they're like the head counselors.
Yeah, and they're going to the place, but yeah. There's a rope. No, he's in the middle of the street, right?
Yeah, he's just standing there, and he has the pole that he got impaled with.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he uses to kill them.
Yeah, and the
metal rod.
I'm like, dude, just go around him. Like,
yeah,
can't you just drive around him?
But I just like how they're. This is what I'm not understanding. Like, there's a big hole in the road behind them. Cause she's like, that's it. We're reversing back to town to get away from this guy. And he's like, stop. And then it's all wet and there's a hole. And he's like, if we get stuck in there, there's no way we're going to get the car out. And I'm like, but didn't they just cross over that?
Yeah.
So how did they get there? How'd they get over it? Like, I don't know.
I don't know why they had to do that.
So it's,
But even then when he's there, like, and he's like, no, I need to go take care of this.
Yeah.
And like, dude, just
and he has the little, he said it's a 22.
Well, I don't know if it is. It looks
like a cap gun to me.
I don't know if
it looked like a 22.
It looks like a little cap gun.
It looks fake.
The reason I called it a 22 is because, from my understanding, that a 22 is like the BB gun of like the firearms world.
I don't know anything about firearms.
Like that's my understanding from what I heard.
It did look really fake. It looked like a prop, like.
It probably was.
His kill is funny as shit, though.
Yeah.
He just, like, Jason just goes towards him, like, if he has a bayonet.
Mm-hmm.
Like when he's trying to shoot him, and then when he stabs him, the noise that Tony Goldwyn, with the, oh! And he just throws him over. And then the chick's like, oh, shit. And then I was laughing my ass off when my wife and I were watching it last night, because mm-hmm. when the girl jumps out of the car, and then she falls into the puddle.
Oh, yeah.
The kill is actually pretty cool. How he just stands over her and he just brings it down. Like,
but how did he do that? Did he teleport? You know what I mean?
He can teleport. Jason can teleport.
I know.
Like, but that dramatic shot after he stabs her in the head. But then there's like the wide shot of him just standing there and her head's like completely underwater with the rod just sticking out.
Yeah.
But then they show the close-up of her hand. She was trying to give him money. Like,
yeah.
Here, you can take all my money. And they show the, like, dramatic... It's like this real, like, with dramatic music with the American Express card slowly, like, floating away from her hand.
When I saw it, I was like, man, Jason, you had the credit card, man. Like, well, you should have taken it.
What's he going to do? Buy a fucking bow and arrow?
But there's, like, this actually, like, there's, like, this real, like, somber, dramatic music with that shot of, like, her hand in the puddle with the American Express card, like, slowly floating away from her, like... Oh, she lost her American Express card. It's a great movie. Like, I don't know. And then I remember I told my wife, like, she screams. And I don't know. Maybe it's just me, like, like just having too much fun with the movie. But the angle that they show her when she screams right before Jason stabs her head in the puddle, mm-hmm. I was like, wow, that woman had a feeling like in every one of her teeth.
That's what you were noticing.
That's what I noticed, though. I was like,
it's not her problem anymore.
They were very detailed.
Yeah.
In the props they used. It's an entertaining movie.
No, but we have to, like, with this movie, we have to do, like, our favorite scenes for all of us. Like, what are your favorite scenes or favorite kills, actually?
I think mine is the one where her head gets implanted in the RV.
Yeah, that's
mine. I call
too.
That the T-1000 kill.
Yeah,
that one's cool.
I like that one, and I like when Sheriff Garris gets, like, folded in half like that one.
Yeah, that was
pretty cool.
Yeah, I like that one.
That was pretty cool. I thought the sheriff looked like a young John Carpenter.
You know who he kind of reminded me of? Like Donald Sutherland from like Invasion of the Body Snatchers. Like that's who he kind of reminded me of a little bit.
Yeah. That one, and then I like when he pulls the girl with the football jersey. When he pulls her through the window and her slippers fall off.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
it was like Halloween 2.
Yeah.
The nurse where her big clogs fall off. And then he, with no help whatsoever. Like, he's just so powerful. He just, like, turns her head completely around.
Yeah.
Like, that kill was cool. I know there's... and then the guy, the dude that's driving the RV.
Mm-hmm.
When he just gets the knife, and that's the other thing. That's the other thing I wanted to bring up. Like all of a sudden, Jason's got like a utility belt.
With all these
weapons on it.
And like he has a little knife. I'm like, where did he get that from?
He has the little Bowie knife, like Rambo.
Yeah.
And then he stabs a dude right in the head.
Where did he get that?
All of a sudden, he has like this utility belt with all these different like weapons to use for different kills.
He has darts too, right?
Yeah.
But then there's like the epic car crash that we were talking about.
Oh yeah, the RV. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That one was cool.
There's a lot of.
It's like it shows how badass he is. Like yeah, bitch. Like I'm awesome.
Like I'm back. Thanks to you, Tommy.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Like after it crashes and there's fire like coming from the bottom of it, and they show like that wide epic shot of Jason standing on top of it, and it's like the Jason music video.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
They could have ended the movie right there.
Yeah,
that would have been awesome. Yeah. No, but I like that as soon as he comes out, like comes back to life, he's like constantly like brutal. Like they don't stop it, you know. He keeps on going, he keeps on going, he keeps on going until the very end, of course.
Yeah.
But I like that part where it's entertaining, it's funny, it has a little bit of everything. It has a horror element. I mean, I wasn't really scared watching it. I mean, when I first saw it, yes, but now it's more like, hey, like, it's cool.
Yeah, like.
But this is the last movie prior to Kane Hodder taking over as Jason.
Yeah.
Because like for all the rest of them, right? It's Kane Hodder, even the New Line ones. Up until Freddy vs. Jason.
Yeah.
Because Freddy vs. Jason is like, kind of like half of Friday the 13th movie. It's more like a hybrid.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but like for all the rest of the Friday the 13th, like it's Kane Hodder after this one.
But like I said before, this movie has one of my favorite climaxes at the end of the movie where I know.
And in the middle of the movie.
Yeah. where you have Tommy out on the boat and he's trying to lure Jason. And he has the boulder, you know, the rock with the chain, with the noose.
And how did that gigantic boulder not sink that little boat?
Yeah. Yeah. But like
it's,
I said.
It's movie magic.
Yeah. Physics don't apply here. and he sets the water on fire. And
yeah. It's all
that
dramatic.
That actually looked very cool. That looked cool.
Yeah. That's the creative licensing of Friday the 13th.
Yeah.
And then... you know what? I have to mention something I never noticed in all the times I've seen this movie that my wife brought it to my attention. Since you were talking about climaxes,
mm-hmm.
after the big mandatory sex scene that happens in, or teenage sex scene that happens in every Friday the 13th movie. Mm-hmm. There's actually a sound effect when the girl runs up to the front of the RV.
Yeah.
And the dude's still in bed, like under the blanket. And I never noticed it, and I had to play it back because I wanted to, like, make sure. My wife told me there's a sound effect of the dude snapping the condom off of his crank.
I didn't notice that.
I would have to see it again.
Yeah. I had to play it back, and I had to listen for it, and I was like, oh, that's bad.
That's fucked up.
I can't remember. Didn't was there, like, a little reaction, like, psh, ah, like that?
Oh, you just hear, like, the little snap when he pops it off, and I was like, oh,
shit. That's gross. Yeah, interesting fact.
Yeah, fun fact.
Fun fact, there you go.
But I'm sure diehard Friday the 13th fans are already aware of that.
Yeah.
But I don't know. It's just this is just an awesome movie. It's fun. It's, I don't know.
Should watch it again.
Oh, and we have to mention the groundskeeper guy at the graveyard.
Oh, yeah. That is funny.
One of the best self-referential parts of the movie is, like, he breaks the fourth wall, like, Deadpool style.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He looks right at the camera, and it's like a double entendre. He's like, some people like her. Like really weird forms of entertainment or something like that.
Yeah.
But he's looking right at the camera when he says it.
Yeah.
So he's talking about the kid. He's talking about the teenagers in the movie that he thinks dug up Jason's grave, but he's also talking to the teenagers in the theater watching the movie.
Yeah. Dun, 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 dun. And then, like, when he's all getting drunk and shit, he's like, that's gonna make everything better. Like, yeah, let me just drink myself retarded.
The cliche drunk.
Yeah.
Like the town drunk.
And then when Tommy goes back and sees that he put up all the dirt back, he's like, what the hell happened?
Oh, yeah.
So, and then he leaves, he's like, no one's gonna notice. Or, like, what does he say? The groundskeeper?
Yeah, like, I don't know the difference. Or something like
that. Yeah, I remember that.
That was funny.
Yeah.
What was the other? No, well, you mentioned it, Toots, before we were rolling. The other self-referential moment.
Yeah, like, one of the girls is like, and I was like, I've seen way too many horror movies.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's Tony Goldwyn's girlfriend.
Yeah.
She's like, I've seen way too many horror movies. When there's a big scary guy in a mask, you don't mess with him or something like that.
Yeah.
I love that they're referencing their movie in their movie. Like,
yeah.
Like, I like that.
In a dumb, funny way, not in a Jason X kind of way.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe one day we'll do a roast of Jason X.
The next Friday the 13th that rolls around.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, if you want a fun, like you said, it's like, if you want a fun Friday the 13th movie to sit around and watch with a group.
In the campfire. Just,
yeah, and just, like, have fun. It's this movie's, like, tailor-made for that sort of environment. Like,
yeah.
I think that's what the filmmakers intended with this movie, so... Watch Friday the 13th, Part 6, Jason Lives.
Yeah, and I don't give a shit. I love the Alice Cooper song at the end, The Man Behind the Mask.
Yeah.
I love that song.
Oh, fuck yeah. Like,
I like
all
that song, too.
All that 80s metal,
yeah,
that 80s hair metal, I adore that music.
Like, what did I say?
Care.
It's the Dream Warriors of the Friday the 13th series. It's like,
yep, I concur. I agree. So, yeah, but if... Honestly, like, straight up, like, if I would give this movie a grade, I would give it a B.
Yeah.
I have that much fun watching this movie. Like, it is not, it's not an A caliber movie.
But
I have so much fun watching this, and I have a lot of respect for the filmmakers being willing to, like, have fun with the genre, like, while they're actually in the franchise.
Yeah.
So, and it's fun to watch. Like, it's entertaining. Like, I would give it a B.
I would
give it a B minus.
I'd give it a B minus.
It's good. It's funny. It's entertaining. The kills are awesome. I mean, there's so many things, like you said, Damien. Like, it's a good movie to sit around with your couple of friends and just watch it.
Yeah, and just you know, just take it all in, or even, like, poke fun at it, like, what's going on.
Yeah.
Embrace the genre cliches.
Mm-hmm.
So that's it's Friday the 13th. It's a holiday for horror fans.
Yeah.
You all have a wonderful Friday the 13th.
Yeah.
And we'll keep it safe.
We're the So that's our That's the That's the Dudes of Horror. Worm Boy's making me laugh.
I'm Worm Boy.
I'm Toots.
and Damien. That's our review of Friday the 13th, Part 6, Jason Lives. Hit us up in the comments if you want us to do any other movie review, any other horror movies.
Yeah, more than likely, Jason X will probably be the next Friday the 13th. Yeah.
Yes, definitely.
So go have fun, y'all. Go watch Friday the 13th movies.
Yeah. All right, see you later.
Later.
Later.